In last year's NBA draft, LaMelo Ball and Anthony Edwards were widely thought to be the only two potential options for the first overall pick in the 2020 NBA draft. But if Amani Bates were eligible for this year's draft, several experts think it would be hard not to take him first overall. Who might be the best player in the nation and the next transcendent talent to enter the league? So today, let's find out if Amani Bates is worth the hype. The 6'8" Bates is a 16-year-old phenom who has been compared to Kevin Durant for some years now. He is playing this season at Yipsey Prep and is committed to Michigan State beginning in 2022. There is widespread speculation that he will reclassify up and head to college or potentially the NBA G League path for the 2021-2022 season, making him eligible for the 2022 NBA draft. He's the best prospect I've seen at the same stage since LeBron James. Longtime ESPN recruiting analyst Paul Biancardi said on ESPN2, when Bates went for 36 points and 10 rebounds in a loss to Chet Holmgren and Team Sizzle. I haven't seen a better prospect than Amani Bates since LeBron James, and he's the closest thing to Kevin Durant skill-wise that I've ever seen. On SportsCenter, ESPN draft guru Mike Schmitz called Bates the best prospect in the entire United States. He's 6'9", can handle like a guard, can pull up from three with ease, and has the type of star quality you want to see in a top recruit. He's going to be able to score at the NBA level like Jason Tatum, and shows you some doses of Kevin Durant. Not quite as long, but has that type of scoring ability. Amani Bates is the number one ranked player in the country, according to ESPN's basketball rankings for the class of 2022. Unlike most top recruits who would join a blue blood program for their lone college season, Amani is committed to Michigan State. However, many sources think that Bates will forego his college eligibility to play in the G League, just as last year's top 2020 recruit Jalen Green did. Of course, if he reclassifies and heads to Michigan State in 2021, not only would it make coach Tom Izzo very happy, it would set him up to be a one-and-done prospect for the 2022 NBA draft. He could also enter the G League path like five-star prospects Jalen Green and Jonathan Kuminga did this season. Despite his blue chip status in the high school scene, Amani says that his college recruitment process was a quiet one, mainly because a lot of people assumed that the NBA draft eligibility rules would change by 2022, allowing high school kids to make the jump straight to the league. The majority of coaches assumed Amani wouldn't go to college as a result, and therefore didn't really recruit him. The new rule, though, was never passed. In Amani, you find a 6'9 versatile hooper who can play just about every position on the floor, do severe damage from the perimeter, off the dribble, and above the rim. A quiet, laid-back demeanor off the floor, Amani's entire persona changes the moment he steps onto the hardwood. He's the ultimate alpha in between the lines, trash-talking to his teammates at practice and letting out loud roars after a tough made basket. Bates is the first high school player to grace the cover of Sports Illustrated since LeBron James, and the two have spoken about handling such intense media scrutiny. Bates may be in the same gym as LeBron soon. Later this season, Amani Bates will face Bronny James in a game against Sierra Canyon. LeBron is expected to attend to support his son, with whom he'd love to someday team up with in the NBA, according to his Lakers teammate Danny Green. So the question is Bates simply an elite prospect that just happened to grow, maintain his coordination, and develop his skill set at an earlier age than anyone else? Is Bates the best freshman prospect or the best freshman player since LeBron? Because there is a huge difference. Point being, Bates' floor in the NBA is a bucket-getting wing. I'd be shocked if he didn't end up averaging 20 points, if not much more, at the next level. I wouldn't be shocked if he turned out to be a perennial NBA All-Star either, at the very least. I don't think anyone is going to question this kid's killer instinct. And yes, there is a real chance that Amani Bates is one day discussed as the best basketball player in the world. And these are all in the range of outcomes for his career. When you can say a 16-year-old's floor is a career 20-point scorer that is on track to earn upwards of $30 million in his NBA career, it's clear we're dealing with someone special. But that's not the way this story is going to be told. The narrative will be one extreme or the other. Either Bates lives up to the hype and enters his name in the race for the GOAT, or he's a bust that was completely overhyped by clickbait artists trying to garner some YouTube subs. The truth, however, is this. Bates could be Durant, he could also be Wiggins. The most likely outcome is that he ends up somewhere in the middle. That's the way these things usually work out. And until we are able to talk about prospects like this and think about players in this manner, we should avoid crowning high school juniors as the best player in the world. Hype is dangerous when it can't be kept in context. Andrew Wiggins is the proof. But anyways, guys, thanks for watching. Make sure to drop a like, and if you're not subbed already, make sure to subscribe. Anyways, guys, I'll see you later. Deuces.